homemade dress, Papa's bangle wasn't big enough. I was standing on the side of the road, the rain falling on my shoe. Heading out for the East Coast, Lord knows I paid some good fees getting through. Tangled up in blue. She was married when we first met, soon to be divorced. I helped her out of a jam, I guess, but I used a little too much force. And we drove that car as far as we could, abandoned it out west. Split up on a dark, sad night, but the feeling it was best. She muttered something underneath her breath as I was walking away. Heard her say, I never did like it all that much, and one day the axe just fell. And I drifted down to New Orleans, where I was lucky to be employed, working for a while on a fishing boat right outside Delacroix. And all the while I was alone, the past was close behind. Met a lot of women, but you never escaped my mind, and I just in a topless joint, I stopped in for a beer. I just kept staring at the side of her face, and the spotlights appeared. Later on, when the crowd thinned out, and I was just about to do the same, she wanders up behind my chair. She says, "Honey, don't I know your name?" I muttered something underneath my breath. She studied the lines on my face. Must admit, I felt a little uneasy when she bent down to tie the laces of my. She said, "You look like a silent type." And she opened up a book of poems and offered it to me, written by an Italian poet from the 13th century. Every one of those words rang true and shined like a burning coal, pouring out of every page like it was written in my soul from me to you. Somehow.